Hey guys, welcome back to Amanda's Favorites, where I have new videos every Tuesday. I am so excited for today's video. This is the Cultivate What Matters launch. It is their 10-year anniversary. I was sent a box to be able to review and share with you. We're going to go through the power sheets. We're going to walk through them. We're going to go through the accessories that they sent, talk about pricing. We'll do pen testing. We are going to do it all today. Power sheets are something that I actually used for about 2.5 years. I didn't use them this past year in 2021. If you follow me, then you know about my planning. I give quarterly planning updates here on YouTube. I make them in their own playlist, so you can check those out and see what I've been doing this year if you're interested. I will try to remember to put that playlist down in the description here for those that are new to my channel and interested in my personal planning. But I also review all different kinds of planners. My goal is to help you waste the least amount of money. It's hard to tell if a planner is going to work for you until you have it in your hands. You can touch it and feel it and look through the pages. I try to show you all those in detail and give you the best description possible to help you be able to make the best decision for yourself in the season that you're in. Let's jump into the power sheets today. Right off, I want to say that I do not have a discount code for power sheets, but I am an affiliate. So if my videos and content have helped you, the way that you can help me to continue to do this and produce content is to just click through my affiliate link to their website. Nothing will look different about their website to you. You will still sign into your account and everything there, but it will give me credit for your sale, which shows them how many people I bring to them, which is how I get these boxes sent to me early. But I also make a small percentage of the sale, which helps me to be able to keep my channel going with all the work and time that I put into my content. So you clicking through my affiliate links means more to me than you can know. It's a big deal. They all add up, all those little clicks. So thank you so much for remembering to do that. You can also just bookmark my affiliate link. So whenever you're shopping at Cultivate or whatever other company, then it's already there bookmarked on your computer and you don't have to remember to come back to one of my videos and click through my link. Thank you so much. Let's jump in. We're going to go through the goal planner first, power sheets, and then we will move on to the accessories. So we're going to move those out of the way for right now. This is something that's brand new this year. They introduced boxes. These were not here last year. These are beautiful. Your box changes color, whatever color box you get depends on what color of power sheets you choose. So I chose the Kelly Green, which when I chose, I only got to see little tiny pictures. So I was lucky. I was sent an email with little tiny pictures and I got to choose early what color they would send to me. I didn't even know that Kelly Green was their special 10-year anniversary color. So I have heard that Kelly Green might be the first to sell out. So if that is the color that you are going for, definitely I would say order on launch day. I hate to be one of those people. Like, I don't like to say, oh, you have to order on this day, but they do have launch day bundles going on. So if you're planning to buy some of the accessories with the power sheets, you can really get a better deal with their bundles. They also offer free shipping usually on launch day and the day after only, but I don't know what they're doing this year. It might only be on launch day. So definitely follow them on Instagram or check out their website for details on that, but they usually offer free shipping. So it's also the best time to order for that. It's a beautiful box. I don't keep all my boxes because I receive a lot of planner boxes, but I think I'm definitely keeping this one in my closet to like save cards and mementos in because this is a beautiful one. I like how it's white inside. The gold foiling is just stunning. And usually, you guys, like I said, I receive a lot of planners to review. I don't rave about boxes, but this one is pretty darn amazing. Here are your power sheets for 2022. Cultivate What Matters Power Sheets, if you are not familiar, is an intentional goal planner. It is not a planner as in your agenda. It's not a weekly planner. It's not a daily planner. It does have a monthly layout per month just to help you be able to map out your goals and intentions for that month. Now, if all you need is a monthly layout, then this might work as your planner also. But it's not a weekly or daily planner. It is beautiful and lightweight. The measurement of this, and I will take the weight of it. It is not a super heavy book. I like that. I love the feel of the book. It is a linen cover, which feels really nice in hand, but it's like coated so that it will slough off any kind of water, or if peanut butter and jelly gets wiped on it, or chocolate, you know, if you're working on your power sheets and eating, not blaming it on the children or anything. And the linen covers, there are 5 linen cover colors this year, I think. And then there is one Blooms. Their Blooms this year is beautiful. This is their Blooms pattern this year. So if you pick the green, I highly recommend picking the Blooms pouch, which I did not do. I already have 2 floral pouches from them in the past, so I was just thinking of getting a different one, but I really should have picked the floral because it would look at that with the green. So first of all, I just want to say your power sheets are $62 and they are very high quality. The paper is 80 pound, 120 GSM. I mean, the tabs are amazing, gold foiling on all of them, the dividers. I mean, everything in here is just honestly top notch. There is color, I mean, all over. I wouldn't say on every page at all, but there's a lot of color, which, you know, costs more to print. It is a stunning planner. It feels good in hand and it is fun to work in. What I always look for is how it looks when I have the book folded over inside, because I don't see the covers of my books a lot. I'm working inside them. So I see the edges of my book and like the tabs, and those things matter to me. And this is beautiful. I love seeing the green with the floral. I really love that they put the floral pocket there. So the inside is almost more important to me than the outside. I love the rounded corners, because you guys know, if you follow me, I talk about I don't love pokey corners. So just everything in this book, you will feel it. It is just quality all over. It feels good in your hand and it is just beautiful, which motivates you to work in it. This is an intentional goal planner that will take you through 12 months of mapping out your different types of goals, habits, big dreams, and those smaller goals. They map them out in 90-day increments. Check up on you through monthly tending lists. Let's walk through this. If you've ever had things in your life that you really want to be motivated to work on, that you want to have feel some accountability on, maybe spending this money on power sheets will give you that accountability to say, well, I spent that money, I'm actually going to work in them. And if you work in them, I will tell you, their system does work, because like I said, I used it for over 2 years. An easy system, it's a simple system, but you do have to do the work. And that's what I tell everyone. You do have to put in the work. You're the one putting in the work. This doesn't do anything for you if you don't put in the time and the work for it. Not to be a downer there, but they have made it so beautiful, it's motivating to work in. They have your word of the year card back by popular request. And I really like this card in here, which kind of guides you through if you're new to power sheets. So open your power sheets, write your name in them, log into Goal School. Goal School is their free enrollment that you get when you buy the power sheets. This is a lot of free content, free video coaching, free power sheet resources, the free library of wildcard pages to print and utilize and put in here, which we'll talk more about. You get a lot of free support and content from Goal School when you buy the power sheets. So that is something to know about. You do have to log in and register for that. Complete your goal setting pages. Oh, no, I went out of order. Sorry. Complete your prep work, which is on pages 5 through 33 of the planner. And then complete your goal setting pages, which are on page 34 through 51. And then fill out your first tending list. We'll talk about that. And then choose a wild card page. That's where you can go to Goal School and print out any of their free library of wild card pages to utilize. Those are pages that can like help you with meal planning, finances, if you want to like clean out your house, a reading list. Now, you can also buy a pack of their wild card pages already pre-printed. At least the prior years that I've gotten them, they are in color. I wasn't sent any this year to share. And so if you don't want to have to print them at home, if you don't have a great printer, if your ink costs too much, then you might just want to pick up the wildcard page pack on launch day. You have your beautiful gold foiling on your cover page. Then you get a free page of stickers. So even if you don't end up buying their goal setting sticker book, these all go with the color scheme of the planner. And you get 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 of their page flags also, which there is room for those for each goal that you make. There is a letter from Team Cultivate here, just kind of like a welcome to the planner. And all throughout, you're going to have motivational quotes. And I will mention, They do a goal prep work day that is like several hours, led by Laura Casey, the creator of PowerSheets. I believe enrollment to that is like half off on launch day, at least it has been before. So if that's something you're interested in, you don't have to watch it live that day. If you can't attend the day that they do it, you will have the playback to watch. Then you go into your prep work, which starts here on page 5. You're going to have 2022 goal ideas. You will notice on all these pages, there is direction and guidance and even examples. They definitely don't leave you stranded. They also put out a lot of free content to help you on their Instagram. They also have a blog where Laura Casey even shares her tending list every month and talks you through that. They used to have a podcast. I don't think they've been publishing any new episodes. At least I haven't heard about them doing that. But you can check out all the old episodes, which I feel like would really help you too and guide you through if you're new to PowerSheets. I will say before I did PowerSheets, I had never done any guided goal planner before in my life. It was brand new to me. And I really feel like PowerSheets taught me to think through what I want to happen in my life. Their goal is for you to think about when you're 80, what is going to matter? And those are the things that you want to work on and tend right now and cultivate in your life. So it's really looking long-term, those things that are important to you. Of course, you can put on your tending list, you know, short-term things like, you know, you're moving and you need to get all the windowsills painted, or you're going to be cleaning out the whole house that year. I did that 1 year with my PowerSheets. And I designated one room per month so that it wasn't overwhelming, or like a set area. You know, like 1 month it was the kitchen, the next month it was the office closet. That way I could just find one day that month to work on that one thing to clean out. And it actually went really well. It motivated me, it held me accountable, and I cleaned out all those areas of my house that year. That was about 3 years ago now, and I need to clean out all those areas again. It's funny how that happens, right? But you can definitely put those kind of things on here too. But also those things that are even more important to you, like family relationships, maybe your scripture study, those type of things. Okay, so I will try to stop going on tangents and just walk you straight through here to start with. What do you want to cultivate in 2022? These are just your goal ideas and thoughts, just a brainstorm page. I'm not going to read through every page because obviously that would take us like 2 hours or more. So I'm just going to kind of flow through them a little faster. You have about me pages, but you will notice all the direction given on every page. What makes you come alive? What fires me up? Then you have a cultivated life evaluation in these 8 categories: health and wellness, friends, finances, spiritual and personal growth, focal relationship, family, work and learning, and recreation. So in all those different categories, you're going to think about where you are, and they give you direction on that, and choose a number and think about, you know, is that where you want to be, or what could you do to move yourself forward there? Good things, like what's worked in the past, people you're grateful for, challenges, what didn't work in the past, what I learned. Get ready to break free. These are pages about who you are, who I really am. I'm moving past fear. These days are your legacy, the big picture, and then your big picture vision. These are those 8 categories for the year. And then you're going to think about in each category, your big picture vision for each category, writing just out some thoughts and ways that you want to grow long-term in each one of those categories. Living it out this year. My cultivated year, what I'm saying yes to, what I'm saying no to. I mean, the prep work in here is extensive, but it is worth going through, you guys, because by the end, you really are honed in. This step-by-step guidance really does hone you in on, you end up with exactly what you want to work on, what is important to you. I can testify that after doing 3 years of prep work in here. It truly does that for you. Imagine it, your intentional year. Types of goals. I really like the way they divided this up to types of goals. There are habits, finish line goals, like the goals that move you from where you are now to where and who you want to be. And then the big dreams. These goals are often new, bold, or life-changing, and they explain what each one is. So you're going to think in each category to check off what kind of goal you're working on in each category, because it kind of helps you see, like, if you had all big dream goals, that might be a lot to work on in a year, you know, but if you have some habits, some finish line goals, and some big dreams, you'll see that you have, you know, a little more of a mix that you might be able to work on. And then it helps you narrow down where your focus should be, and you have a rough draft of your yearly goals and lots of guidance points. As you draft your goals, they're telling you all these things to consider. So this really is teaching you page by page. It is literally walking you through and teaching you. It's not like giving you questions without any guidance or help along the way. And here's my recommendation. I should have said this first. If it is your first time going through Power Sheets, I really recommend reading through the whole prep work section, like reading everything through like a book. It doesn't take that long. Before you start working on anything, before you start writing in it or brainstorming, I know lots of people would say, oh, just jump in and start. But to me, the first year I got it, it really helped me understand the whole process by just reading through the prep work front to back and kind of looking through the entire Power Sheet, seeing the flow of it, seeing what it was going to ask from me every single month, and quarterly refreshes. Just getting the whole flow of it the first time helped me as I was filling it out. Now, the next previous years, I didn't need to read through, you know, everything first, like a book, but I did read through it as I did it. But just that first year, if it's your first time, I really found that helpful. Then you have your yearly goals. You might see a little outline of a flag here. That's where you can stick your flag stickers. There are also more in your sticker book. You can assign a color to each goal if you wish, or maybe you're going to color code them by what category of life they're in. So people have done all those different kinds of things. I'm not really a color coder. I think it's a great way to do it if it works for you. Okay, here is your vision board. And then you have take the pressure off, lots of guidance, turning challenges into opportunities. I like this, thinking about what might stand in your way of achieving a goal and then how to move past it, like challenges that we might all relate to: comparison, isolation, overambition, perfectionism, punishment, or postponing celebration. That's a really good teaching page. Then you go into your goal action plans. You have 8 of these for 8 goals. So for each goal that you have chosen for the year, and they're not telling you you have to choose 8, that's just how many slots they're giving you, but it's really up to you how many goals you choose. You have a 2-page spread per goal. And so for each goal, this is your whole action plan and like your page to brainstorm, break it down into mini goals or action ideas or sketching a plan, or you can download a wildcard page and use it here. So they have some wildcard pages that you can tape in here. They're made to print smaller than the page and you can washi tape them in. So you have room for your goal, your why, what motivates me to make this goal happen. Your type of goal, is it a habit, finish line, or big dream? Your area that that goal is in, resources needed for that goal. This plan aligns with my, does it align for your big picture, your yes, no list, or your word of the year? So they're trying to make sure you're focusing in on those things that you said were most important to you. What success looks like for this goal at the end of 2022. What might happen if I don't start or make progress on this goal? The people who will be positively affected by this goal, I love that thought, and how I will have fun with this goal along the way. I think those are all great things to think about when you are thinking about what goals are important for you to work on. So you have enough for 8 big annual goals here. And you know what? I even say sometimes you might not have 8 at the beginning of the year. Some goals might get finished before the year's up, or some goals might get abandoned just saying, you know what, my life has changed now big time and that goal is not important for the season I'm in. And if you have some extra goal pages left, then you can always add on some other goals if you wish to. Just remember to be flexible. There are no rules in this planner or in any planner. Use it how it works best for you. Then you have a yearly overview. This is to help pace yourself. It's done by seasons, okay? So, or quarters, you could say, but they call it season 1, season 2, season 3, and season 4. So you can think about kind of what you're going to be working on in each month to make sure that you're not trying to cram in too much to one specific time, especially if you look and say, oh, well, my kids are home for these 3 summer months, you know, and think about where you'll be or vacations you're going to take, you know, holidays that are there, and when is really the best time to put down working on certain things. Here is my pen test page. I decided to use these two pages they left blank for your wild card pages to tape any of those in here. I did all my pen tests. This is amazing 80 pound, 120 GSM paper. You can see you couldn't even tell that was written on until I told you, I bet. So all the pen, all the mild liner, the Erin Condren dual tip markers, the Paper Mate flares, you cannot see anything there. Definitely no bleeding through, but even really show through. It is a white paper that takes pen really well. It's not slick or overly smooth at all, so not like a plum paper. It's not like a writing on butter paper, but it doesn't have a lot of tooth. It's not like a lot of tooth. So I would say it's a normal paper that absorbs the pen well, but is a thick one and feels luxurious. After those wild card pages, then you come into your first month. Every month has this super thick cardstock, like coated page with a nice quote, a different color, beautiful Mylar tabs with gold foiling on both sides. And this is what you're gonna get every single month under your monthly tabs. You have a prepare well page for the month. So you have important to-dos, I'm excited for, on my mind, and I'm hopeful that. This is kind of like a brain dump for the month to clear your mind. Then you go into the monthly layout. I mentioned that they had added this in the past couple years. They didn't have this when I first started doing Power Sheets. Many people requested this, and I love that they listen to their customers and really try to make tweaks and changes every year based on what you guys ask for. Their users, that's who is important to design it for. And so it's a typical Sunday start, and you just have a monthly layout and a notes room. And like I said, you could use this for your like appointment planning if you're someone who doesn't need to have another weekly or daily planner. But this was put here for you to be able to outline your goals, the big picture. You might also put vacations, things like that, so you can see when you're trying to work on what here. I've also heard of people using these spreads in all different kinds of creative ways. Like they might use it for their fitness tracking, what they're doing for movement every day. They might use this spread for writing a gratitude every day, something good that happened every day, or just a little memory of the day. So it could also be a memory keeper or just highlighting the good. These two pages are not in every month. They're just here in the beginning to kind of teach you the first month of the new year and then how to make a tending list. So they're walking you through what the tending list is. So you won't see these pages repeated in other months. Every month you will get a brainstorm your month. And this is broken down into monthly ideas, weekly ideas, and daily ideas. These are your big picture action items or projects, things to take action on consistently, like every week, or daily habits that you want to cultivate. Which areas does this month's goal cover, and make a plan for the month ahead. Then you have your tending list, which is perforated. And so you can tear it out. 1 year, I tore out my tending list every month and I kept it on a clipboard up by my desk. It was just what worked for me that year. So you can definitely leave it in your Power Sheets. I've done that before too, and I just leave it folded over on the edge of my desk or on the bookshelf behind my desk to the month I'm on. I've done that, and then I've also torn it out. So it is perforated if you want to tear it out. Most people decorate up their tending list with at least some color, mild liners, or a few stickers. You have place for encouraging words, priority. It says the month you're on. And then these are your monthly action items. So the big things, the big picture things, are the big actions that you want to get done that month. Then weekly action items are those things that, you know, need to happen every single week. That might be things even small, like a chore that you need to do around the house every single week. Or it might be more like a heart goal, like interacting with your kids every single week. You know, having a one-on-one time with each of your kids every single week. Do you want to mark that down? Daily action items and habits are broken down for you to do those things daily. It could be movement. It could be scripture reading. It could be walking. It could be taking your vitamins. So that is broken down there for you. This is really the gold to me. Now, the prep work is amazing and helps you to see what you want to work on. I will admit, the first year I thought, what is this prep work going to tell me that I can't come up with on my own? But honestly, it led me to make some new goals that I don't think I ever would have made without the prep work guiding me there. This tending list is gold though, like I said. This is like my favorite part because it is a check-in on one page, one simple page. And when I tore mine out, I would usually tape it back in here on like the monthly divider to just have it left in my power sheets. And at the end of the month, you have a month review. Now, if you're seeing this and you're a user of power sheets, you're seeing that there are some changes from last year. I'm not going to pull out last year's and do this side-by-side comparison because if you have last year's, then you're able to do that as I'm going through it. And I think that's kind of annoying for the people who are just watching the first time because it confuses them. They don't need to know how last year's looked. And we all just need to look at this year's because this is what we're going to be using this year. So we need to see if we like this. All right, month in review. Who or what am I most grateful for right now? Good things this month, what I read or listened to, goals that are growing well, favorite memories from this month, what's not working right now, I am saying no to, I am saying yes to. This is different and it is very free flowing, I feel like. You could do doodles or pictures in here or put stickers. It's just giving you that guidance, but it's giving you space for each thing. So every month flows that way. You have your prepare well page to kind of brain dump, clear your heart and mind for the month. You have your monthly layout to use however you wish. Oh yeah, some people have used this for meal planning too. So if you just need a second monthly layout, and that might go with one of your goals because feeding your family well might be one of your goals. I think including the monthly layout is definitely needed and was a wonderful addition when they did that. Brainstorm your month and then your tending list and then your month in review. Now, when you get to the end of each quarter, I'm going to show you they have changed this from last year. Your refresh is here. So it's kind of like every 90 days, you're rethinking your goals. You're rethinking, are those the same things I want to keep working on? Look at what progress you've made and decide what's important for you to keep. So here is your goal refresh. You have a cultivated life evaluation again, like you did in the beginning, because you're going to write your previous score and then you're going to write your new score to see how you're doing in each category, to see the progress you've made. They're gonna ask you to think about something here. Try this at home. Wish you had an extra 24 hours in the week. And then they talk about this. Let's find out how you're using your time this quarter. So each quarter, it's kind of a different thing. They're doing a different try this at home. They're giving you tips to start that time tracking. What I'm saying yes to this quarter, what I'm saying no to this quarter. They also have a time tracker that you can download there and they give you instructions on how to get that. Keep moving forward. They're taking you through which goal have you made the most progress on, which goal do you feel stuck on? So kind of like reflection for the quarter. Then after the reflection, you go into my refreshed goals. You're going to write your goals here for reference again, like a master list of your 8 goals. If you're color coding, then you can use those same things here, the same flags and everything. But once again, this is the time when I think through my goals and mine don't always remain the same. I am very flexible and I know that they will not be locked in stone. Life is ever changing, especially in a family. And sometimes we have to decide that things that we thought were important were not the important things and other things that have come up that are very important. So I love having a quarterly refresh. Plan for the season ahead, your goal and action ideas for the season ahead. These pages are just to be used for notes, brainstorming, mini goals, action ideas, or sketching a plan for the next 3 months out. Now you can download and experiment with different wildcard page formats from their library. But they have put their simple brainstorming format here. You can always cover those up with a wildcard page if it works better for you. Then you break your goals down here. That's where you could do mini action steps. Now, last year, they did have more of a breakdown, and I'm wondering if this is a wildcard page this year. So in the refreshes, they would do your yearly goal and then your mini goal with that and then the action steps under that in these refreshes. And I know many people love these pages, and I'm wondering if they have made these into a wild card page. I don't know that, but that is something for you to check on if you loved those pages. Okay, so that is the flow. Then you go into the next month, but you have a refresh every quarter. And I will just flip through here and show you the dividers as we flip through to your next refresh. So here is your refresh after June, and it is the same thing, except your try this at home is different. This one is feeling overwhelmed by all that's on your mind. Let's briefly quiet the noise and give our minds a chance to rest and be restored. When we do this, we have space to gain a new perspective on the days ahead. So this is a lot about, like, maybe you're unplugging from technology. You're going to spend more time outside, set aside your to-do list, read or watch something that challenges you. They give you a lot of ideas, and you're going to do prep work on what's firing you up right now. Then a keep moving forward page, the same thing. And then your refresh goal page, the same thing, the same planning and brainstorming and breaking down your goals for the next 3 months. Then you go into that next month, and then you have another refresh here after September. Yes, before October. Same pages. The only thing that's different is a try this at home. This one says, are you a morning person? People I'm grateful for right now. Then these pages are the same, and you're breaking down pages. Then you end with November and December. We didn't really look at those dividers, did we? I don't think I showed those. But they're very bright colors. Just, I love the dividers. They look beautiful. They have a great feel to them. Then at the very end, you have a hooray, high fives. You did it. Honestly, if you completed your power sheets for the whole year, I can tell you, you deserve a high five, because it does take work and checking in, and it takes dedication, and you definitely accomplish things along the way. I know, because I did. So here is your 2022 year in review, and here are your 2022 things, like favorite memory, best new habit, song on repeat, these type of things. And then let's celebrate and get ready for 2023. So that is a walkthrough of your power sheets. Let me know all your thoughts if you have used power sheets down in the comments. I would love to hear how they have worked out for you. I would love to hear your thoughts on them, if you're going to use them again this year, how many years you've used them for, and if you're new to power sheets and thinking about trying them, I would love to hear your thoughts also, and if you've used any other goal planners. Now, let's take a look at the accessories. The first thing is the goal setting sticker book. This is $15. They come out with a new one every single year. It's in a book page format. This year they have their beautiful new florals. I love these. These are just made to motivate you and use all over your power sheets, on any pages you wish, you know, throughout the monthly pages. Just put them on there to motivate you and add color. These are probably some of my favorites out of the whole book. Then you have the washi tape strips, which are also beautiful. You have color code your heart out with all these page flags, you guys. If you color code your goals, you have two pages of those, and on each page you have three of each color. Then you have color coding dots in here. Boom. You have two pages of those, and then color coding hearts. So they all go along. You have, these are the same as those. So all the colors flow, but these are like your little emoji things. And they say these correspond to the categories in the cultivated life evaluation. So in those areas in the cultivated life evaluation, those coordinate. So they do tell you what each stickers were made for up here, which I really like, instead of just getting a sticker book and you're like wondering and thinking, where am I supposed to use these? I didn't mention that, but they don't have that on every page, but on the pages where they need it, they do. These dots can be used on your tending list next to each goal. So all those monthly items, all those weekly items, daily items, if they coordinate, like you've made all your health and wellness goals green, then every month you can easily see where those green dots are. These correspond to the three types of goals that you might set: habits, finish lines, and big dreams. These are celebration. These are prioritize it, more prioritize it in gold. Cultivate contentment. Just beautiful reminders to slow down and look at all that's good in your life. Highlight the good. I love these new ones. These look very different from any previous year. And these are a favorite in Laura's handwriting. Just some motivational quotes in the gold foiling. So that was fun. I love the way they end and say that was fun. This sticker book is made where you have a gold band to keep it shut if you want to keep them all in your sticker book. It's a beautiful book. You have a little page marker. I took all the packaging off this stuff just so it would be easier to use. And if you wish to use this in your power sheets, you'll probably get one that matches the power sheets better. But you can leave this on whatever page you're working on the side or on the top. I actually love these to use in novels and books we're reading just for school or me at home. We use these page markers for that around our house, but they also work well in planners and in the power sheets. And they have them in several designs. They come out with new ones every year. Those are $5. Oh, we need the planner back. This is brand new this year. This is your Snap In bookmark for $6. Let's take a look at how this baby works because we have not had one of these before. Oh, it snaps in very easily. I had not tried this yet. Works perfectly, has their cute little Cultivate emblem grow leaf there and can help you find your spot. Oh, I'm so glad they came out with that. I think so many people are gonna love that. Okay, that's your Snap In bookmark for $6. Then we have your little everyday notebook here. And I did write down, you guys, I work so much better when I write the pricing actually in the product or put a sticky note on it. I don't know why I wrote it all up on the big page because it's so hard for me to follow along while I am making the video. I'm trying to see how much this is. Everyday Notebook is a sewn notebook. It is $10. It's like coated on the outside, so if you spill anything on it, it would be completely fine. It feels great in hand, and if you just lay it out and give it a little massage there, it lays completely flat. It has just gray lines, and it has the beautiful blue. Now, I don't know if the color changes based on which notebook you get. Since this one's blue on the outside, I bet it does. And you have the blue carried over here. You have the little Cultivate leaf and the blue at the top and the bottom. And this just makes a good journal, brain dump notebook. If you like to carry a notebook in your purse or the car just to jot things down or take notes in church, this makes a great little notebook or gift with a pen. It's your everyday notebook. And then these are so popular. Like I said, I didn't get the one that matched my power sheet. So you're going to have to see past that, you guys. But these pouches, this accessory pouch is $20. It fits over your power sheets perfectly. You can put it just over the front cover, or you can put it over your whole power sheets. And that way you can carry pens with you. You can carry your sticker book with you if you wish. And you can have all your planning stuff just in one spot with you. Now the sticker book, we did talk about this last year. You have to finagle it a little bit to get it to fit in there. But it does fit. But you have to turn it a little bit. And I was doing it at a bad angle with my microphone in front of me. So let's try it at a better angle there. Yeah, it's not that hard. But your sticker book can fit if you wish for it to do so. A nice zipper, you can completely wipe it clean. These pouches are great for bringing things in the car or the diaper bag for little kids too. Like a snack pouch, a little toy pouch, because they're like wipeable and you can pull out the lining and dump out crumbs. So they work really well for that also. Let's try it on here. I do have a whole pouch comparison on an IGTV with different companies' pouches, and Cultivates are in there. So you can check that out if you're interested. I will try to remember to put that down in the description of this video. Okay, guys, so that wraps it up. I will love to hear all your thoughts down in the comments below. If you are purchasing from Cultivate, I ask you to please consider using my affiliate link if my videos and content have helped you. I would so appreciate that. Thanks for watching, guys. I value your time and I appreciate you being here. Take care of yourselves, take care of others, and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.